Hello friends, and welcome to TechProMan. Friends, today in this video I am here with the part 3 of how to revive a lead acid battery. And I hope you have gone through the part 1 and part 2. I have created one playlist on my channel. You can watch those parts if you have missed out, and you can see what we are talking till now. If you are directly onto this video, if you are directly there on the part 3, and if you wish that you want to see the part 1 and part 2, then you can go back and check out my parts, which are uploaded on the YouTube channel, and the playlist is also there. What do you think, what would have happened with the battery? And do you think that it would have been revived? Friends, as I said earlier in my video part 1 and part 2 both, that it really depends on the battery, how it has gone weak or how it has gone dead. The battery that I have taken here for testing was sitting idle for probably a couple of weeks, and before that it has gone through a extensive charging and discharging cycle of probably three and a half years, and it was completely discharged. So now the case was that it was not even getting charged, it was not holding the charge, there was no charge retention on that, and hence I have taken up these videos and tried to demonstrate that whether these batteries, lead acid batteries or sealed maintenance free batteries, can be revived or not. Yes, there can be certain circumstances wherein you won't be able to revive those batteries and they would be dead and you can't do anything out of it. But there are chances, the way that has happened to me. Yes, you are right, you are thinking right. The battery has revived and it is showing 12.161517 volts, and it has not yet gone through charging cycle, but definitely de-sulphation has happened. I kept on for 1 week probably. I did it for the last video was uploaded on 21st of April if I'm not wrong, and then I kept the battery for 1 week on de-sulphation, tried to de-sulphate it, and there was no charging cycle in that week. And then I disconnected the de-sulphation unit or the temporary circuit that I had built, and I kept the battery idle for 2 days just in order to remove, or in order that the surface charge is not getting accounted. Yes, there is a surface charge whenever you do de-sulphation or charging that gets accumulated on the battery because it has been exposed to 14 plus volts. Now, keeping this in mind, I'll show you a video wherein the current battery status, which I have recorded today morning, is visible. You can see by yourself that the battery is showing 12 volts, and I had discussed about cold cranking apps in my first video, part 1, and I did a test of that battery on my bike, and yes, it does crank the engine and the engine starts. And it cranks once, twice, thrice, every time. Now, one more thing I want to tell you, that I have been telling you that I will whiteboard two circuits. One is available on Google if you search, so that I will not whiteboard, I will just make it a block diagram for that. And the other capacitive desulfator I will show you. So I will bring my whiteboard here. I will not use that character right now for this video, not for this video now. A couple of videos I have done with that character, and definitely I will be coming up with few more if you want, but definitely in further videos he would be a part of my whiteboarding. But as of now I will be doing my own whiteboarding or greenboarding, whatever we say, and I'll show you that circuit, I'll explain you that circuit, I'll show you the battery status, and one more thing I had promised that I will show you, that is how can you test maintenance type batteries that are distilled water type batteries, means the hygrometer and the specific gravity of the battery or each cell that you want to test. I'll show you that. I have taken a sample video of that, and I'll choose a sample for one cell and you can do it for the rest of the cells. There is one more thing or one more method what you can use for testing a battery's specific gravity, but it is not recommended, and it should not be done unless and until you are sure that you are going to empty out that battery. Yes, if you are going to empty out that battery and you are going to replenish the complete electrolyte into it, then you can test this method. That's addition of a pinch or 2 pinches of baking soda into the cell of that battery. If the effervescence has come out, that means there is still a bit of sulfuric acid, but it is not the exact measure of the specific gravity. The exact measure that you can have is through the hydrometer. I'll show you that. I'll show you both the videos, and in video I'll do the explanation as well. Friends, if you are new to this channel, if you are watching this video and you haven't subscribed this channel yet, then please hit the subscribe button and do click the bell icon so that you get the notifications whenever I upload a new video. Keep liking my videos, and I'll be coming up with different concepts, different techniques, and different do it yourself kind of stuff. Apart from that, what I wanted to tell you is that whatever you do or whatever you think of these videos, just take it as a knowledge purpose. These videos, whatever I have recorded or whatever I am demonstrating, is for demonstration purpose, and I am not escaping any of my safety measures. So be sure, and I hope you all are safe there, safe out there, and stay home, stay safe. See you, and let's check that video, and then we'll start the whiteboarding. Bye.
See this. This is the battery that I was mentioning, and it's at 12.16, so the results are good. Okay, coming to this video. In this video, I will show you how to measure the specific gravity of a cell of a lead acid battery. And the equipment lying there is a hydrometer that you can see. Make sure all your PPE are on, and you take care of your legs, hands while working with batteries. What you need to do is, in order to test the specific gravity, you need to dip the hydrometer into the cell and pull the liquid out into the hydrometer. And the float inside the hydrometer will float in the electrolyte that has that got filled into your hydrometer. You can see this. If it is above your water level and it is 12.5 or 1250 above, then it's a good cell.
Okay, so I hope that you are able to understand and put these pieces together. I have showed you since part 1, part 2 and part 3, there were understanding of the battery, then the desulfation part and everything. Over here I have showed the battery status by connecting the voltmeter to it and measuring the voltage across the terminal. Now these terminals are showing 12 volts and above. Okay, the desulfation that has occurred, that is, there are plates inside the battery. These plates expand and contract. So whenever you do a desulfation on a voltage which I showed in part 2, and you give a pulsating voltage on high frequency DC voltage, okay, these plates expand and contract, and in a way they shed the sulfate that was there on the outer side of these plates, or which got deposited on these plates. So the shedding of this sulfates is called desulfation, and these plates become free and again available for reaction, chemical reaction, and generate electricity. So this is what the phenomenon is, as this is what I have tried right now, and to some extent it worked. Now I will do the charging, and this battery will definitely accept the charge because it is already accepting the charge, and about 12 volts now. So hoping for a like on this video. Let's do a green boarding now, because I do remember that I have a green board to present. Okay, so here's the green board, and we'll be looking at the green board for the picture to appear. It's still not there. Okay, here.
Friends, you will be able to see the circuit on your screen. I have maximized it. Please note, a note of caution, this is for demonstration purpose only. Do not try this. Whatever I have done is basis my understanding and I know what I am doing, but there is a hazardous DC, high voltage DC coming out of it. So do not prepare this circuit, do not attach this circuit, do not connect this circuit and touch the DC lines. It is a life threatening, you know, so do not try this at home. It is harmful. So friends, finally concluding this video, I hope you understood the concept and the demonstration that I carried out on the batteries and all the bits and pieces that I have given out as a knowledge in part 1, part 2 and part 3. Friends, hoping that you gain some knowledge, I would request you to comment me in my comments box below if you want any further details out of this experiment or demonstration that I carried out. Okay, so signing off from this video, see you in next video. Bye bye.